Time now for Anderson Cooper in New Orleans and AC 360. Anderson.
Larry, thanks very much. Live in Louisiana on day 70 of this disaster. It's our sixth week here in Louisiana. The last thing they need down here right now is a bad storm. Yet take a look. Tropical Storm Alex now in the Gulf. The question tonight, will it put the cleanup and well capping work in jeopardy? Will it deepen the nightmare? Reports are parts of the sea already too rough for skimming. Chad Myers tonight tracking Alex joins us shortly. But we begin, as we always do, keeping them honest. New evidence, new outrage that BP still seems to be playing number games and word games instead of being open and honest about the spill. In an interview with the Times-Picayune, BP's Doug Suttles, that's Chief Operating Officer Doug Suttles, said that knowing how much oil is gushing out of this well is irrelevant. BP never considered flow rate important, says the headline. His exact words were, quote, the flow rate has never impacted the response. He says it's, quote, extraordinarily imprecise, and we took a view very early on that we didn't think you could do it, meaning measure the flow rate, and we didn't think it was relevant either. He says BP had always planned to overreact, his word, to the spill, planning for a worst-case scenario. Well, first of all, if that is true, how come they're still scrambling to get containment vessels here and boom and skimmers and just about everything else? But to continue to claim on the one hand that it's just too hard to estimate the oil and besides it's irrelevant, and then on the other hand to have pushed a stunningly low estimate of 1,000 barrels spilling as BP did for weeks after the disaster, well, that just does not pass the smell test. And it's not just me saying that they didn't truly plan for a worst-case scenario. It's now the U.S. government. As the Picayune pointed out on June 11th, Coast Guard's Rear Admiral James Watson concluded that BP's response plan was based on unrealistically low flow rates, and he wrote to Doug Suttles the following. He said, and I quote, I'm concerned that your current plans do not provide for maximum mobilization of resources to provide the needed collection capacity with consistent with revised flow estimates. That was Admiral Watson, June 11th, saying they hadn't planned well enough to capture enough oil. But what is truly stunning is Doug Suttles' response just 2 days later to the Coast Guard. He wrote back saying, quote, we will continue to adapt our plans as more is learned about the flow rate from the well. So they're going to adapt their plans as more is learned about the flow rate, but then he says the flow rate is irrelevant. Doesn't that seem a complete contradiction? On June 13th, he tells the United States government that flow rate matters. 12 days later, he tells the Times-Picayune and the public they don't matter. It's irrelevant. Well, Mr. Suttles, who won't come on this program, by the way, though we invite him every day, the truth is not irrelevant. It may be hard to find, it may be hard to measure, but it matters. It matters because your company will be fined based on the flow rate. It matters because the public has a right to know what your company has done. It matters because scientists will be studying the impact of oil on animals for years here. And it matters because an entire way of life for oystermen and shrimpers, fishermen and others, an entire way of life is threatened. Why is BP now determining what matters in this disaster? Why are they still telling the people here what is relevant information? BP has been trying to control information from here from day one. They don't come on the broadcast, as we've pointed out. We invite them every night. That's their right. Now they've sent their own employees, though, to start reporting on the spill. On their website, the BP so-called reporters in the Gulf have been portraying a very different version of what's happening here. Here's a report from BP, a guy named Tom Seslar in Houma, Louisiana, where the fishing industry is devastated. But according to the BP reporter, he writes, quote, much of the region's other businesses, particularly the hotels, have been prospering because so many people have come here from BP and other oil emergency response teams. That was BP's Paula Colmar, another of their so-called reporters here. On the 26th of May, reports about looking for tar balls on Pensacola Beach and finding none. Well, let me tell you, she could on that date have gone to Paso Lutra in Louisiana, where the oil was already smothering the marshes and no one was cleaning it up. BP's so-called reporter, Tom Seslar, had a BP ID and no problem apparently getting past security to get on the beach, something other actual reporters here were prevented from. Here's how he described what he saw when he got on the beach. He said, quote, it, meaning the beach, was closed so that a mighty BP-led force could continue preparing it and be ready to defend it against any oil that might ride in with the white-cap waves crashing ashore from the Gulf. A mighty BP-led force. Hard-hitting BP-ridden reports from the disaster zone. That is apparently relevant to BP, but determining how much oil is gushing and spreading and coming ashore, that apparently is not. I talked about it moments ago with political contributor James Carville and Plaquemines Parish President Billy Nungesser, who spoke earlier. James, what do you make Doug Suttles now coming out and saying after all this time that the flow rate is irrelevant, that it doesn't matter to the effort or overall how much oil is pouring out of there every single day.
How do I say this delicately? Let me think. He's lying, okay? He's lying. The statute says that if they show gross negligence, it could be up to $4,000 a barrel fine.
Right. So they first tell us if they're ruled as grossly negligent.
And I'm the worst lawyer in the world. I think I could take on the beat legal team and find them grossly negligent. Okay, this is not going to be a real hard case based on what we know. So if 4,000 barrels a day, they started out saying that it was 1,000. They now going to put new instruments. They're going to find out that it's 80 to 100. So 80,000 times 4,000, what, I don't know, what is it, 32 million a day?
And Doug Suttles, in his own email and letter to the Coast Guard, because the Coast Guard recently, early June, said, look, you know, your response isn't enough based on the flow rate. Doug Suttles said, you know, well, we'll change our response as we learn more about the flow rate. So even in his communication to the Coast Guard, he acknowledged that it is important to know, and yet publicly he's saying it's irrelevant.
How long are we going to let them tell us what they're going to do? When is the government going to say, get out the way, we're going to measure it, we're going to put our own experts down there? Why are we letting BP still run the show?
In this morning's paper, in New Orleans paper, in the Times of the Year, the story saying that the government wants them to put more instruments down there so they can
better measure. Right, they're going to put new sensors in the new containment.
Why don't we just have someone go down and put the sensors and send in the bill? Because Mr. Suttles is lying, okay? He's just out and out, bald-faced lie. All of the people that are working for BP, all your PR people, everybody out there spinning this, he's lying. You know it. I know it. The world knows it. Why don't the government just go down, put the sensors, tell us what the flow rate is, charge them $4,000 a barrel for everything that goes out, and let's get on with our business.
What's so bizarre to me is that for the first several weeks, the government was going along with BP saying, in essence, well, look, we're planning for worst case scenario, so it doesn't matter exactly to know the exact number. But I mean, if you're fighting a fire, you need to know how big the fire is.
Well, we keep seeing it rolling ashore day after day. We've got more coming ashore than we're cleaning up. So it definitely matters. It matters to the wildlife. It matters to the wetlands. It matters to the way of life in Louisiana. We've got to know what we're up against. And the dispersants are keeping it below the surface, so we don't know, because it's coming ashore under the surface and making it impossible to fight.
Every time that we've gotten a figure, it's been wrong, and it's been wrong on the downside. My own personal view, and I wish
not just the downside. I mean, we're talking from 1,000 barrels a day. That's what they said initially. To now 65,000.
But we know we're going to 80 to 100. That as soon as they put the instruments, everybody that knows the scientific team knows that they're not comfortable with this. There are people on there that know this. The guy from Purdue took one look at it and said it was 75,000 barrels.
Right. After watching a 30-second video,
everybody knows the 35 to 60 is just BS. No one believes that figure. I don't believe it. Nobody in the scientific community believes it. And the government is now asking them to put the monitors on that. Just go put the monitors on that. Hire a third-party contractor, but BP has every interest in not doing this, and we got to understand that.
Yeah, and all along BP, I mean, it was really only a few weeks ago that the Coast Guard insisted that monitors be put down there, that sensors actually be placed for the first time.
Right.
I mean, we went for a month and a half without any sensors actually being placed down there.
And the disbursement's the same thing. Quit using them. How much are you using? And we get no answers, and we allow it to go on. It's absurd that we put up with this.
We should obviously point out that we asked BP yet again to come on the program to talk about this. They declined. But what's interesting is they've actually now sent out two of their own quote-unquote reporters to kind of bring back stories for a BP blog. And the stories they come up with, one, they had problems finding the oil. One that was about searching for tar balls. And the reporter wasn't ultimately not able to find, and they heard there were tar balls in Pensacola. They went and found happy people on beaches.
Well, they can go to Pensacola and find tar balls. If they want to find 4,000 acres of thick oil, destroying wildlife, eating up the marsh, and in the marsh where everything is dead, come to Plaquemines Parish, because it is destroying our way of life on a daily basis.
We went, you and I and Anderson, and we all went down there, must have been 5 weeks ago, found all we wanted to find.
We're sucking it up daily, and it keeps coming back.
Yeah, that article was written on May 26th that they couldn't find the oil, yeah. I think was the exact date. We're going to have more with James and Billy just ahead. They were just getting started. Let us know what you think. The live chat is up and running at ac360.com. A month ago, the state of Louisiana asked BP to pay for mental health treatment. $10 million is what they asked for. A month later, they're still waiting. What is BP doing about it? Well, they did send a letter. We'll read you the letter. We're keeping them honest. And later, Chad Myers tracking the storm now heading across the Gulf.